Okay, I have 62 questionnaires with raw data, and they're all been filled out by hand by my participants. And now it's time to enter all this data into Excel. So let me show you how I do it. The first thing I do is put a unique consecutive identification number on top of each questionnaire. And the next step is to start Excel, like so. And in Excel, my first row will be where I put my headers. And the second row is where I put the first respondent. The columns, well, that's going to be my variables. My first column header is ID. And the first respondent has the identification number 1. My next header is Q1 for question 1, where the respondents had select 1 out of 3 responses. And I code these responses 1, 2, and 3. The respondent selected the first one, so in this example, I will code this with the digit 1. Next is question 2, where they could select multiple responses if they wanted. And in Excel, I give each response its own column, Q2A, Q2B, and Q2C. If the participant has checked the box, I will write the code 1 in Excel. Otherwise, I will write a 2. And in this concrete example, the respondent has selected the first alternative, left the second one blank, and selected the third. Consequently, I will put a digit 1 in Q2A, 2 in Q2B, and 1 into Q2C. Moving on, the header for question 3 is Q3, of course, and I designed this question as a ranked scale, as you can see, 1 through 5. And the respondent has marked the second scale step, which means that I enter the digit 2. Okay, question 4, Q4. I code this dichotomous question with the digit 1 for yes and 2 for no. And in this example, I write a 2. Question 5 is an open question, and in Excel, I usually need 2 columns for this to work. First, in column Q5A, I type in the written reply from each respondent verbatim. And in the next column, Q5B, I will later categorize the responses, i.e. interpret and code the responses with digits. I talk more about this in another of my tutorial videos. And question 6 is, as you can see, a so-called semantic differential. For this respondent, I code it with the digit 1. Okay, that concludes the first questionnaire. Let's do the second one together. Q1 is coded with the digit 2. Q2A is a 2. Q2B is a 1. Q2C is 1. Question 3 is 5, and question 4 is coded with... the digit 1. For Q5, I just type in whatever the respondent has written by hand. Question 6, finally, is coded with a 3. Okay. That concludes the second questionnaire. I'm going to continue now and enter all this raw data into Excel, but there's no need for you to watch that. So I'm going to end the video now. And if you enjoyed it, please don't hesitate, leave a like or subscribe. And in the next video, I'll show you how I transform all this raw data into professionally looking figures and tables. So until then, have a nice day. Bye-bye.